I took another person's life. I can't live with that burden.
Ah! Oh, my God. Ah!
What happened? Where am I?
You're in the hospital. You tried to kill yourself.
Kill himself. He was holding a loaded gun, and instead he jumped out of the window of a two-story house. It was nothing but attention-seeking. He's got a broken foot. Of course, they'll keep him overnight for observation. And who pays for that? John Q. Taxpayer, that's who. This is why I voted for Trump. I'm a Trump man. Always have been. Give him hell, Trump. Drain that swamp. Build that wall. Lock her up.
Does that taste good, Pigeon?
Oh, does this bird seed taste good? Is that your question, Marcus? Okay. Does this bird seed taste good?
Mm-hmm.
No, it doesn't taste good, you witless gadfly. I want to eat what you're eating, but I can't because it gives me diarrhea. This is the only thing that doesn't give me diarrhea. My asshole is so raw, it's just red and raw from all the damn diarrhea.
Okay, that's not really breakfast talk.
Oh, should we talk about my piss? How it's dark, almost orange, because I'm so dehydrated on account of how much diarrhea I have when I'm not eating bird seed. This delicious bird seed. Go f*** yourself. Out of hell with it. Give me a bite of that. Oh, that is good. Oh, it's going to burn coming out, but you can't say it's not good going in.
I'm Emily von Breyer, Carlton von Breyer's daughter, and I was just asked to leave by the grieving widow.
Ah! Oh, sorry about that. I had pancakes for breakfast.
Ugh, gross. She just married him for his money.
Now, young, you don't know that. Why, perhaps he was a world-class cunnilingist, a magnificent eater, a proper muncher.
Just stop.
There has to be some evidence down there that the police missed.
Ooh, Young is on a roll. You didn't talk much at the beginning, but now, boy, you're talking a lot. Go, Young. Marcus Pigeon, what are you guys doing, huh? You're only good as your last line of the dialogue.
Well, how on earth would we get down there?
Ooh, Marcus, getting it in there. Come on, Pigeon, what do you got to say? Whoa, Pigeon with the unexpected physical move.
Pigeon! You asshole!
I thought you could fly. Aren't you an angel?
I'm a ghost!
But isn't your catchphrase, time to fly?
That is Michael's catchphrase!
Oh, you know what? I think you're right.
Hey, everybody. You got a new mystery. Oh, damn. You ordered from Tuss Grill. Did you guys get my usual? The five fish platter?
We did not order anything for you because no one thought about you. Now, give me that mystery. Dear Mike Tyson Mystery Team, I am 7.5 years old. I made a wish on an eyelash and it didn't come true. Please help. Margaret Moses. Go f*** yourself, Margaret Moses.
Look, if wishes came true, you think I'd be living in this hellhole? You know how many times I wished I was a singer and everyone knew my songs and knew who I was and that I mattered in this world?
Uh-oh. You just said your wish out loud. Now your wish will never come true. You'll be stuck here forever doing whatever job is your job.
It's fine. Come on in. You can head on back to the bedroom. I'll be there in a second. If you'll excuse me, I have a client. Margaret, there's chicken nuggets in the freezer if you're hungry.
Oh, the mom is a trailer park whore. That old situation.
Well, looks like we have some time to kill. Anyone have any ideas?
Well, why don't you...
No, I'm sorry. What were you going to say?
No, I'm sorry. You go.
No, please.
I was going to say, why don't you tell us about the wishing well?
Interesting how different people are. I was going to say, why don't you drive back to that trailer park so I can... that whore. But fair is fair. I said you go first. So, let's hear about this wishing well.
Not all wishes should be granted. Some people wish for some terrible things, you know, to happen to other people.
Oh, yeah, I do that all the time. Like, right now, I'm wishing that car coming the opposite way would swerve in our lane and kill the driver.
My God, you don't even know that person.
No, I'm talking about the driver in this car.
You. Ugh. Your father set this clock completely wrong. It's only 9:42.
Well, let's just pull over and wait.
We're still not going to go back to the trailer park? You get me all hot and bothered with all this bush trimming talk, and now you want to just sit by the side of the road? What am I supposed to do with this massive erection?
I don't see anything.
That's because it's inside my body, because I'm a bird. I don't see your tits. What's your excuse? Oh, that's right. You've got the body of an 11-year-old boy. Well, you don't see anything.
Could you please help me find him? Best regards, Edward Cute. Probably didn't need to write my full name twice.
We shouldn't condone this behavior.
It's errand day, Marcus. Everybody gets to choose one errand. And Pigeon wanted to go to the park so he could buy some drugs.
$40 for a half ounce. Either the market for crystal meth fell off a cliff or I just bought a bag of rat poison. Oh, only one way to find out.
Finally.
Well, it's not rat poison, but also I'm not getting that hard-dicked, crazy crystal meth tingle either. Jesus, what the f*** is happening to my legs? Oh, this is horrible. My blood is thick. My brain is freezing cold. Everything is...
What is he doing?
Is that something we should be concerned with?
There you go, little guy. Now, go find the Mike Tyson mystery team. Fly! Pigeon!
Whoa. That was transcendent.
Dear Mike Tyson mystery team, my name is Edward, and recently I discovered that I have an identical twin brother whom I've never met. Wait, sounds familiar. Have we met a before? I could swear we met a young. Do you remember a
For God's sakes, you idiots are the c***s. The name is obviously pronounced Cute. Have you never met anybody named Cute? By God, it's a common surname. Why, when I was a boy, the family at the end of the lane, they spelled it with a C, and they pronounced it Cute. Oh, yes, I remember him well. Harry Cute and his wife Ima. I'm a Cute, and he had two lovely daughters, Yura and Bia. You're a Cute and be a Cute. To the Mystery Mobile!
Incredible! After all these years!
Who are you calling?
Oh, why do you care? Why are we even still here?
Number one on my bucket list is to kill Pigeon.
What? What the f*** are you doing?
This is amazing, Michael. You're going to complete your entire bucket list today.
What are you waiting for, Dad? Do it. Pull the trigger.
What? Please, please, no. No, what's the matter with you people? Wow. That really was transcendent.